Greetings and welcome to the powerful, profound, hilarious, and pretentious world of pastoral poetry.
Look there, those city slickers, lost in thoughts and stresses and the noise of the bustling city. Can you spot the poet? Remember, they are shy creatures who prefer meter to meeting people. There he is, crouching cowardly in those bushes. This one is a Greek poet named Theocritus, who fills his endless time furiously writing about a picturesque countryside in his newest work, Idols.
His mind is filled with the dreams of Microsoft wallpaper-like hills and toned farmers whose beauty are only surpassed by Wallace and Gromit. As far as scientists know, this is the first significant example of this species engaging in such a work, which has been titled Pastoral Poetry. Pastor comes from the old Latin word for shepherd, and all poetry coming from the Latin-speaking word for pretentious.
After a few hundred years, a couple of Renaissanceans found themselves tired of the dirty, busy, task-filled life of the city, and decided what they really wanted was the dirty, busy, and task-filled life of a shepherd.
With there once arose a new surge in the pastoral format, as poets like Walter Raleigh, Christopher Marlowe, and Michael Drayton took on the art form on their own. Let's take a deeper look at one of their works. This is The Passionate Shepherd to His Love by Christopher Marlowe. Take a moment to read, please.
Now, unlike many poems that are filled with convoluted and ridiculous rules, Sestina's villanelles, pastoral poems are like the very sheep that roam the country land, free and ruleless.
While this specific poem does have both a rhyme scheme and a clearly visible stanzaic structure, there is no set structure or rhyme scheme required to be a pastoral poem. Instead, it is defined by the way that it romanticized the simple, idyllic world of rural life. Notice the focus on serene nature, simple pleasures, and smokin' shepherds.
In a time when flushing your toilet meant a gaudy looing feces out of your window, it is clear why this style became so popular during the 1500s. The country seemed to offer a beauty and sense of agency that was seldom seen in busy urban life.
As time has progressed, pastoral poetry has definitely become far less common, but there are still hints of Theocritus' Idols in plenty of modern-day culture. Think Take Me Home, Country Road by John Denver.
Life is older, older than the
or even, if you really squint your ears, Lil Nas X's Old Town Road.
You can whip your Porsche. I've been in a valley, you ain't been up off that
in a broader sense, the idea of transporting to a simpler, easier life being so tantalizing is universal. Who wouldn't want a simple and fulfilling life in the countryside?
In the end, that is probably the reason that pastoral poetry rose to the heights it did. Well, that and the irresistibility of shepherds.